The reason... What's up everybody, welcome back to another episode. As you can see, I've now moved from Wellington to the sunny Bay of Plenty, where I've got way too much sun. But more on that a bit later. For now, let's talk about this thing. This is my 2021 model Specialized Stump Jumper Evo Expert. I bought an S5 version, and compared to my last bike, it's actually about 10 mils extra reach. I could have gone for a smaller bike, as well, but I kind of like having a big bike. It makes me feel a bit more confident on the trails. So the reason I traded the Specialized Enduro for this bike is actually the Enduro that I had was really awesome. It was great riding, but I'm not a full-time racer. I don't race all the time. If anything, I'll show up to the odd event. The Enduro, it was just such a plow bike, whereas this bike, it's still a race-ready machine. It's got 150 mils of travel in the rear, 160 in the front. That's all I need, especially with 29 inch wheels. I've found that it's a lot more playful on the trails. It's easy to maneuver around, even with flat pedals. You can still go fast on it. You can still do big jumps, all the same stuff that I do on the Enduro. It's just a bit more of what I want out of a bike. And so for me, I'm actually compromising less by going to a shorter travel bike, because it's just so much more fun. In terms of component spec, I'm running it largely the same as what it ships with. I haven't changed a whole lot apart from the wheels. I actually managed to keep the wheels off of my Enduro. So I traded in alloy wheels for carbon wheels, and I just love the way they feel. They're really stiff and they're really strong. As part of that as well, I kept the tires on the wheels, of course. So I'm running an Assegai 2.5 up the front with an XO Plus casing, and a Maxxis Dissector 2.4 in the rear. It's got all the usual Specialized mountain bike trimmings, like the X-Fusion dropper post and a SRAM drivetrain setup. So I'm running an X01 drivetrain at the moment. It's one of the new ones with the Lunar cassette, and I just find it's just a little bit too pedally. I lose all my momentum and I slow down and I'm just grinding away there. So in the future, I may swap that out for a 50 tooth instead, but in saying that, I still love the group set. It shifts really well, even when it's dirty, and it's just really nice. It comes with a Fox suspension package on it, so I've got the 36 Performance Elite fork on there. So it's got all the same internals as the factory forks. It's just not got that nice Kashima coating. And then I've also got the DPX2 Performance Elite in the rear as well. It's a pretty good shock. I quite like it. It's got a low speed compression adjustment. I may swap it out for a coil. I'm pretty curious to try it out, especially with this bike. You can run a coil unlike the normal stump jumper, so I'll see how I go with that. So some of the cool points is that adjustability that the bike comes with. So I've got three positions that I can put the headset into, so that's either really steep or really slack. Right now I'm running that in the middle position, and I've also got a horse link flip chip kind of system in the rear, so it ships in the high position. I rode it like that for a wee while, and then I actually moved it to the lower position, which lowers the bottom bracket height, grows the wheelbase just that little bit longer, and actually ends up slackening the head tube just a slight amount. So a couple of things that I don't really like about the bike is the glue in between the frame and the protectors that they've put on it doesn't seem to hold up very well. A little bit of dust gets in there and then the whole thing peels off. It's a really well thought out design. I don't know if anyone else with a Stump Jumper Evo has had that same problem, but for me, I'm going to end up re-gluing the trim inside there. Also, during one of my rides, I lost the little bash guard screw underneath the frame. and if I didn't notice it, I would have lost the whole thing altogether eventually. In saying that, it's such a beautiful bike, especially when you see it in person. You can see the carbon fiber layout through the paintwork, and it's just really well finished. It won Pink Bike's Bike of the Year. That's gotta be good for something. So professional bike reviewers seem to really love it, and I do too. Anyway, that's enough about my bike. You'll be seeing me ride it quite a lot in the future with upcoming videos that I've got going, and also some upcoming trail builds that I'm doing. So if you want to keep up with me, then by all means subscribe. You don't have to if you don't want to. But until next time, happy trails, everybody.